Good day everyone. I'm Dr. Osama Ibrahim from Easy and Different Radiology. Here on Easy and Different Radiology, I'm talking about all things related to radiology diagnosis. So if this is something you are studying and looking to be perfect, you have found the right channel. Today, I will talk about the pediatric skull as part from the anatomical series for FRCR part 1. Today, this is series number 8. I'm talking today about the is it a suture or a fracture. The pediatric skull is specified by these sutures, which are developing and unfused until periods of life. So this one in the midline separating the parietal bone on both sides is called the sagittal suture. And in the anterior view, you can see the frontal bone here, and this frontal bone can be separated by another accessory suture here, which is called metopic suture. The frontal bone is separated from parietal bone by another suture here, which is called the coronal suture on both sides. However, if you look at the skull from the posterior, you can find this occipital bone, and occipital bone separated from the parietal bone on both sides by sutures, which is called lambdoid suture. So this is the main sutures of the skull separating the skull bone or calvarial bone, and can be appeared in the pediatric age group. And this is another diagram which is showing the lateral view of the skull and also showing the frontal bone anteriorly and the parietal bone after that separated from each other by these sutures, which is called the coronal suture. And also there are occipital bone posterior, this one, and occipital bone separated from the parietal bone by these sutures, which is called lambdoid suture. And there are another sutures arising from the lambdoid and passing anteriorly. This is which is called the squamosal sutures, and the squamosal sutures separating the parietal bone from the temporal bone, as you see here. Also, there are another sutures which are continuous with the lambdoid sutures inferiorly and anteriorly. This suture is called the occipitomastoid suture. So this is the main sutures, or the main sutures which can persist in the adulthood in the and can be appeared in the pediatric. The next issue I will talk about it today is the skull views, because if you know which view you are, you can suspect which sutures and its site. And the next step, if after you know the site of the sutures, the normal site of the sutures, you can know if the pathology appearing or the lucent line which appeared is a sutures or a fracture, and answering the questions of the presentation. First of all, when you're looking in the skull and like this, and can you see the orbital wall and the mandible? So this view is called the anteroposterior view. However, when you're looking the style, the skull from the lateral view, it is lateral view and easy to differentiate it. However, this view, which cannot see or can discriminate the orbit and the mandible like this view, so this is called Town's view. And Town's view have a specific view for occipital bone. This is the occipital bone and the nearest sutures, as we see later in the next slides. So the main three views for the skull: anteroposterior view, lateral view, and Town's view. We have five main sutures which persisting in all adults, and these sutures, as we see here in this skull, I will mention that. But first of all, which view of this skull, anteroposterior, lateral, or Town's view? Because I can discriminate the orbit and the mandible, so this one is the anteroposterior view. So which are the five main sutures persisting until adults? The first one, this arrow referring to it, if you can suspect which sutures here. The sutures in the midline separating the parietal bone on both sides is called sagittal suture. This is one from five. The next arrow here, which is referring to sutures in the lateral aspect of the skull in that view, anteroposterior view, is called the coronal suture. However, This arrow referring to the sutures which appearing here arising from the sagittal sutures in the anteroposterior view. So these sutures in both sides also is called the lambdoid sutures, which appearing in anteroposterior view. It is posterior in locations, however, can be seen here in anteroposterior view. The coronal sutures only seen in the periphery of the film superiorly, like this sutures and like that one. However, this one which arising from the sagittal sutures is lambdoid sutures on both sides, right lambdoid sutures and left lambdoid suture. And the squamosal suture or occipitomastoid sutures can it be seen in that view, anteroposterior view, can be seen these two sutures. It's placed here in the most lateral aspect and inferiorly, the squamosal sutures. Occipitomastoids can be seen only seen in the lateral view, as we see in the next slide. So, and now with this view, a new view to see the other sutures. This view is called lateral view because the orbits appearing anterior. So this is the lateral view of the skull in the pediatric age group. And the sagittal sutures cannot be seen in that view because the sagittal sutures in the midline, which is separating the two parietal bone, which appearing here superimposed on each other. So the sagittal sutures cannot be discriminating clearly in that view. However, this arrow and that arrow referring to two anterior sutures, because this is anterior. So referring to anterior sutures separating the parietal bone anteriorly and the parietal bone posterior to that line. So this is which is called the coronal suture. However, this arrow referring to another two superimposed line and separating the parietal bone from the occipital bone, so this is the lambdoid suture. If you look at the lambdoid sutures, it can be continuous anteriorly here and forming that sutures which is separating the parietal bone from the temporal bone. So that sutures is called the squamosal sutures, which cannot be seen except in the lateral view. Squamosal sutures in both sides can be seen as two parallel lines here separating the parietal bone from the temporal bone on both sides. What is the other fifth sutures, which you consider as the main sutures and persisting in all adults? The fifth one and the last one is the occipitomastoid, which extending also from the lambdoid sutures to the mastoid regions, from the occipital to mastoid, so it's called occipitomastoid suture. So this is the main five sutures which persisting in the adult. What about this view? This view also showing the main sutures in it, and this view don't you can't recognize the orbit or the mandible. So this view is called the Tones view. Tones view meaning the imaging of the skull from the posterior. So the main issue in this view is the occipital loop, and so this arrow referring to the midline sutures separating two parietal bone from each other, which is called sagittal suture. And the more anterior or more superior lucent lines arising from the sagittal sutures is the coronal one. However, the more inferior and inferior one and posterior one is the lambdoid sutures. If you trace these lines, it can be continuous with the sagittal suture in both sides, and this one also continuous with the sagittal suture. However, the more superior one is representing the coronal suture. So this one is the occipital bone, and this one parietal on both sides. And these three sutures can be seen here in that Tones view. However, also again, squamosal sutures and occipitomastoid suture, better to see it at the lateral view. So after finishing the more main five sutures which are presenting in the adults, there are another three accessory sutures that can be seen in the pediatric age group, and these sutures occasionally persisting to the adulthood. The image here referring to again to one view from the skull. If you can suspect or tell which view this one, that view I can see the orbit and the mandible, so this one is the anteroposterior view. Anteroposterior view I can discriminate the sagittal sutures and the lambdoid sutures on both sides. And this is a parietal bone, coronal sutures appearing here at the upper part of the film. However, here I talking about the accessory sutures. The first one of the accessory sutures is this arrow, which referring to that one before I can see the frontal bone completed or fused to each other. However, if it is separated by these sutures, it is called the metopic suture. This is one from the accessory sutures, which should be disappearing sometimes or occasionally persisting in the adulthood and considered as one from the accessory suture. This is another view which you can see the sagittal suture here separating the parietal bone from each other and the coronal suture anteriorly separating the frontal bone from the parietal. However, there are persisting suture here which is called the metopic suture also, and this is another image for another patient which confirm the presence or persistence of the metopic suture. This one in the because I can discriminate the orbit. So this is the anteroposterior view. So this is the sagittal sutures, and the suture which arising from it is the lambdoid suture. Coronal sutures appearing at the upper part of the film in that view, anteroposterior view. So now we take one from the accessory sutures, the metopic one. What about the other two? This is the lateral view of the skull, and this is the anterior because the orbit appearing here, and there are two main sutures anterior. This is the coronal sutures and lambdoid sutures posteriorly, and the squamosal sutures which are appearing here also in the lateral view, and occipitomastoid suture. All these sutures are main sutures, not accessory one. What about the accessory sutures which I talking about it in that slide? This one it's appearing at the parietal bone because it is the bone between the coronal and lambdoid suture. So the parietal bone, there are one suture appearing from it, and that suture is called accessory parietal suture. Accessory parietal sutures, these sutures are the most sutures which can confusing with fractures. However, if appearing short like this, not extending to the temporal bone, and also not causing widening of the or separation of the bone, so it considered as a suture. And this is another view which is showing the also accessory parietal suture. This view is the anteroposterior view, and you can discriminate the suture here at the parietal bone. The third accessory sutures which can be discriminated and occasionally persist in the adulthood is called the Mendozal sutures. However, this is the tones view because the orbits is not seen clearly, and there are sutures which extending here from the lambdoid suture. This is a lambdoid suture in the right side, and this is in the left. There are suture extending from lambdoid suture medially, and this is which is called the Mendozal suture. Mendozal sutures extending from lambdoid suture posteriorly and medial. So in the tones or anteroposterior view, you can discriminate it extending medially, and in the anteroposterior view also appearing here. This is another diagram which is showing the tones view. Tones view can see also the foramen magnum and the Mendozal sutures appearing extending medially from the lambdoid suture. If there are lateral view, it appeared extending posterior to the lambdoid suture. After I finishing my presentations, I would ask you one question. This is a question of presentation. Is it a suture or a fracture? And I will give you 10 seconds to decide. Actually, there are lucent line extending through this stone view through the occipital bone, and also appearing here. It also extending to the parietal bone, and this site is not the occasional sites for normal sutures. So this is considered a fracture. By this way, you can discriminate between the fracture and suture. Another case also discriminate if it is sutured or fractured. This is the coronal sutures, this is the lambdoid sutures, squamosal sutures, occipitomastoid suture, and this is in the anteroposterior view, sagittal sutures and lambdoid sutures. There are one sutures appearing here and not extending to the temporal bone, so this one is considered an accessory parietal suture, not fracture. The last question, is it a suture or a fracture? Again, this is lateral view and Towns view showing a lucent line extending through the parietal bone appearing on both Towns and lateral view. However, this line is extending through the parietal bone and extending down to reach to the temporal bone also. So this is considered a fracture. The lucent line is much more extensive and continuous through to the temporal bone. So it considers a fracture, not a suture. Let me summarize my presentation. There are five main sutures which can be persist in all adults: sagittal sutures, coronal sutures, lambdoid sutures, squamosal suture, and occipitomastoid suture. And there are three sutures which considered as accessory sutures, and these sutures appearing in the infants and toddlers and can be occasionally persisting in adulthood to adulthood. These sutures is a metopic suture, accessory parietal suture, and Mendozal suture. The most common one is a metopic, and the most confusing one is the accessory parietal sutures. I hope I provide you with a clear knowledge about the pediatric skull sutures and how can discriminate it from fractures. And you can follow my Facebook group by the same name, Easy and Different Radiology, or watch more than 100 presentations in my YouTube channel. You can wait me also Wednesday and Sundays as usual for a new presentations. If you feel satisfied with the video, so don't forget to subscribe, like, share it to receive any new videos like this in the future. Thank you very much for watching. And have a nice time.